हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ हिमांगी गोपाल कृष्ण दिवेकर, माय ग्रुप मेंबर कंप्राइजेस खदीजा, अनम एंड सदा। टुडे वी आर प्रेजेंटिंग अ टॉपिक इंडिजीनियस मेथड ऑफ फिश प्रिजर्वेशन। प्रिजर्वेशन इज द प्रोसेस और एक्ट विच कीप समथिंग सेफ फ्रॉम डैमेज एंड डिटोरेशन। प्रिजर्वेशन प्रोसेस इज फॉलो टू स्टोर द फूड फॉर लॉन्गर टाइम। व्हेन वी डू द प्रिजर्वेशन बिफोर वी हैव टू प्रोसेस द फिश। In that, we are cleaning the fish thoroughly with the clean water so that the mucus which is present on the epithelial layer of the fish is removed. Along with that, whatever the uncontaminated part is present, it is also removed, and dust particle or the other contaminations are present on the fish is removed so that it does not cause a problem in preservation. There are the four methods of preservation. First is the drying method, second is the smoking method, third one is the salting method, and fourth one is the fermentation method. We will start up with the drying method. Drying method is commonly used technique for the preservation. In the drying method, we preserve the fish with the help of the sun dry method. The fish is before drying, the fish is thoroughly washed with the clean water. Whatever the visceral part is present in the fish, it is removed by making a simple incision in the abdomen, and whatever the viscera is present inside the fish, it is removed. Basically, in visceral part, we are talking about the abdominal cavity and the gut region of the fish. Fishes are dried for the several days in the direct sunlight by spreading over the bamboo platform in a thin layer until the moisture content gets totally evaporated to prevent the fungal growth. The bamboo bed is made up of just only arranging them the vertical and horizontally. It is arranged the bamboo bed. So drying method, basically we are using this bamboo bed, and the other method is used. This is the simple cot which we are using. On the cot we just spread the fish and we are exposed to the sunlight. So what are the objectives of the drying? We are preserving the fish for the further use. Secondly, we are preserving the nutritional value of the fish. The nutritional value which is present in the fresh fish, it is not same as present in the preserved fish. It has a less as compared to the fresh fish, but we can utilize this fish for the later use. To make a product both commercially and nutritionally acceptable, we using the method of drying the fish. The second part we are talking about the advantage of drying. What are the advantages? Dried fish are processed through the sun drying or dehydration method. What is the difference between the sun drying method and dehydration method? Sun drying method, we are directly making the exposure of fish to the sunlight, but dehydration method, we are exposing the fish to the sunlight. Along with that, we are considering the other parameter. We are taking the other parameter in consideration, like the humidity of the area, then the temperature. These are the other parameters are considering in the dehydration method. If we compare the dehydration and sun drying method, dehydration method is advanced method in the sun drying method. The water content, when we are exposing fish to the sunlight, the water content is reduced due to the microbial activity cannot run in the normal rate. The rate of the microbial activity is reduced due to the spoilage of fishes does not take place. Unless why we are using the drying method? It is a primitive method or traditional method, and other part, it is a very less expensive and comparatively simple procedure are carried out during this drying method. Dried fish that remains stable for most of the ambient temperature, and it remains for the longer time. Disadvantage of the drying methods are, this process can only be carried out when the bright sunlight is available. So this procedure is basically carried out during the month of February till the end of the May before the rainy season starts. It is the long duration is required. Basically, dry the fish, minimum 3 days are required, and it is maximum days are depending on the exposure of sunlight and the area where we are drying the fish. It may be extended up to 10 to 12 days. Possibility of contamination is high in the ड्राइंग मेथड, बिकॉज वी आर डायरेक्टली एक्सपोजरिंग द फिश टू द सनलाइट, इट इज प्रेजेंट इन द ओपन एरिया, सो ड्यू टू दिस देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ डस्ट पार्टिकल्स आर देयर, सैंड पार्टिकल्स आर देयर, अगेन द इन्फेक्शन ऑफ इंसेक्ट्स आर ऑल्सो देयर, सो ड्यू टू दिस वी आर एक्सपोजरिंग द फिश इन टू द डायरेक्ट पार्ट डायरेक्ट सन, सो देर इज अ नो कवर्ड, सो द एंड बेसिकली दिस ड्राइंग मेथड इज कैरीड आउट बिसाइड द सी शोर, सो ड्यू टू दिस दीज आर द बेसिक प्रॉब्लम्स आर देयर, एंड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट इज देयर, वी हैव टू प्रिजर्व द फिश और वी हैव टू प्रिजर्व द फिश बाय द प्रीडेटर्स, वी हैव टू प्रिजर्व द फिश बाय द प्रीडेटर्स, लाइक वेन वी आर कीप द फिश इन द ओपन एरिया, सो देर इज अ प्रॉब्लम ऑफ बर्ड्स, लाइक अ क्रो कैन बी इजिली यूज दैट फिश एज देयर फूड. शेल्फ लाइफ एंड द फाइनल प्रोडक्ट ऑफ दिस फूड इज नॉट यूज फॉर द टू लॉन्ग पीरियड एंड द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज वेरी लेस एज वी कैन कंपेयर, द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट इज नॉट एज अ गुड एज इट इज फ्रेश फिश. सो टू माई नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज एक्सप्लेन बाय मिस खदीजा.
The second method of preservation is smoking. Smoking has long been used as a means of temporarily preserving fish. The steps in the smoking process are not necessary not only for safe preservation but also to produce good flavor and aroma. Carp, suckers, buffalo, catfish, salmon, trout and chubs may be successfully smoked. A safe, high quality product can be produced using the following brining and smoking procedures. Certain steps in brining and smoking process require careful attention. Brining. Use correct amount of salt in the brine. Use enough brine for given amount of fish. The temperature during brining must be no higher than 40 Fahrenheit. Use similar size and kinds of fish in the brine. Smoking. There should be uniform heat treatment of all fish in the smoking chamber. Use fresh catch, dressed fish, wild or filtered, wash fish thoroughly. Types of smoking. There are two types of smoking, cold smoking and hot smoking. In cold smoking at temperature before 30 to 35 degree, it require longer time than hot smoking. In hot smoking at temperature above 70 degrees Celsius. These are two instruments used by ancient people to do the fish preservation by smoking techniques.
Okay, so myself, Khananam, and my topic, or you can say the subtopic, is salting. Salting is basically one of the type of preservation technique which is used to expand the shelf life of the fishes. And in salting, salt is a preservative agent which is used to increase the, or you can say which can make the condition better of the fishes. And salt is not used in freezing, icing, and except that it is used in almost every technique. If you take drying also, smoking is concerned, it is used in every preservative technique. So now we will be seeing about the process of salting. Before salting, the fish is beheaded, that is the head part is removed, then it is gutted, the gut is removed, and then it is split and the salt is applied inside the visceral cavity. Visceral cavity is basically the abdominal cavity, and then the scars are made with a knife, and scars are made for the deeper penetration so that the salt can travel more nicely and it can get immersed into the fish flesh properly. Then the fish is kept into the metallic cemented tub so that the salt water can be removed, and after 3-4 days it is taken for drying. So now, why salt is used in this? Salt basically, it coagulates protein and it stops the microflora bacteria formation, and it makes the enzyme inactive. So basically, because of that, the salt is used. Now we will be seeing the types of salting. Basically, here I have mentioned the four types of salting, that is dry salting, wet salting, Ken salting, and monocuring. Ken salting and monocuring are the types of wet salting only. Basically, major two types are dry salting and wet salting. Again, in dry salting, also the fish is beheaded. It is cutted and a split is made so that the salt can penetrate into that properly. And then a salt is applied on the fishes, and the fish is kept into the tub. And then the after 2-3 days, or you can say minimum after 48 hours, the fish is removed and then it is washed into the brine. Brine is basically a solution which contains NaCl, that is our common table salt. And then it is kept for drying. Now, from dry salting only, you can understand that in this the fish is dried in 2 or 3 days, and then it is transported to the market. It is packed and transported to the market for further use. Then in wet salting, the similar procedure is followed, but the fish is not dried, okay? The fish is directly wet, and then it is packed into a bamboo basket and it is transported to the market. Basically, the difference between dry salting and wet salting is that in dry salting, it is dried, kept on a bamboo rag, or you can say on the bamboo ropes. In wet salting, it is not dried. Only the difference is this. In Ken salting, the fish is not only on the surface layer the salt is applied. On the upper layers, the salt is not applied, only on the surface. So there is not proper penetration of salt, and because of this, the fish spoil much more easily as compared to dry salting and wet salting. And in mona curing, the fish is not split, okay, directly. They don't cut the fish. They just remove the head part, and through the head part, they insert the salt into it. And it is also one of the type of practice through which the fish is preserved. Okay, here there are a few pictures which you can see is related to salting. Now, what are the issues which we face during the process of salting? One is pink and red, okay? Pink and red, some bacteria, they are halophiles. Halophiles means salt loving. Okay, they can grow under that condition also. So in this condition, even there is slight exposure to oxygen, na, these are aerobic bacteria. Even there is a slight exposure to oxygen or any moisture, then growth of the bacteria starts and the fish will appear more reddish and more pinkish. So if the flesh appears more reddish and more pinkish, from that we can understand that now the fish is getting spoiled. Second is dun. Dun is basically the spoilage. Molds are formed on the fish, okay? From the flesh only, on flesh, na, green color ka layer appears. And when you will see from the, you can make out itself that the fish has spoiled. But if the spoilage is less, na, only the mold is formed on the upper layers. But if the spoilage is for more days, the mold can penetrate into the flesh and the whole fish will be getting spoiled. Now, case hardening is also one type of quality issues which people face during salting. Case hardening, if the fish is during dry salting, if the fish is dried for a longer period of time, then the fish gets very hardened. Okay, so if the fish is not handled properly during transporting, the fish gets fragmented and it gets break. Case hardening basically means for a longer period of time it is dried, like normal duration se bhi zyada the fish is dried. In that case, the fish gets extremely hard. Okay, thank you.
Fermentation is one of the oldest and most economical method for preserving food. The microflora that occur naturally in the process increases the nutritional quality of fish and adds unique flavor. Small fishes such as Apontius, Isomus, Danzicus are mostly preferred for fermentation. It has several local names such as Acidal, Sepa, Nagri, Hikoti, etc. Fish spoilage. Fresh fish will spoil very quickly. Once the fish has been caught, spoilage progresses rapidly. In the area of high temperature, fish will spoil within 12 hours, which make them unconsumable. Type of fish spoilage. Autolysis, bacterial spoilage, chemical spoilage. Conclusion. Proper initiative and policy implication, financial support, awareness through campaign by the government of the state for the development of fishery sector will definitely help to generate productive employment and income the state. Lack of active participants and lack of farming system approach has been the barrier proper production in fish culture. Local farmer must be aware benefit and low cost production of fishes. Thank you.